So my theme today is parched grapes, wines from the driest places on earth.
This wine, you know, Marnier Vineyard, very polished.
Right.
They use a pneumatic press, about 53-year-old vine age is an average there.
Syrah isn't a guarantee all the time, right? Syrah might be a little bit more affected by vintage. It might be a little less touched by what people do to it.
Here you'll find Kopke, who's notably the oldest continuously producer, shipper of port, whose foundation dates back to 1638.
I've never had a wine from Serbia ever in my life. I didn't even think that Serbia really even made quality wines. But it turns out that Serbia is kind of like the golden era of winemaking.
The wine is Domaine de Calathas, Tokokino. Tokokino means of red. And it's made predominantly 85% from a grape called Kumariano.
When I think about, they say happy cows make great milk. I think of how happy these vines must be.
So that's why I picked a 96 Eagle, because as a wine ages, that TDN, or the expression of it, will increase over time.
A few years ago, I had the opportunity to taste that redhead before it was released out of barrel, and it was like, blew me away.
And to me, this is like a really beautiful balance, interesting play between both styles. And Julian Hard really hit the lottery when it comes to German winemaking mentors.
When we think about natural wine that we can all get excited about, no matter which side of the aisle we sit on, we think of the Gang of Four, Foyard, Lapierre, Thévenet, and others.
And I did the very unpopular thing, and I listed Burgundy South first. And immediately what first started happening is I started selling Beaujolais, and then I started selling Côte de Beaune wines that we've never sold.